गुड मॉर्निंग मैम, वेलकम टू ऑल फॉर ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन कॉमर्स थियरी पार्ट फॉर द फर्स्ट इयर्स इंग्लिश मीडियम. द चैप्टर दैट वी आर डीलिंग विद दैट इज द 11th चैप्टर मल्टीनेशनल कॉर्पोरेशंस एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट सेशन ऑफ आवर चैप्टर. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मल्टीनेशनल कॉर्पोरेशंस? इट इज अब्रिवेटेड एज MNC. So, multinational corporation means the companies which operate its activities more than one country. Means its headquarter will be in one country, but its branches will be established or its activities are going on different countries. For example, one company its headquarter in Sri Lanka and its branches are in India, Japan, Italy, Russia, Rome, next China. If its branches all over the world, okay, if it is occupying the total world, then those companies are known as multinational companies. So let us see the meaning of MNCs and definition of MNCs. So they will cover the total globe. MNCs, multinational companies, will cover the total globe. Yes. So, meaning of MNCs, due to globalization. Globalization means any organization. Okay, any organization can do the business all over the world. Globalization means that anyone can do the business all over the world. Okay, before the globalization, there are certain restrictions, like Indian company should have to work in India, American company should have to work in America itself. They have to work within the boundaries of the country only. But after globalization, it become a global market. Okay, in 10th class in social studies, you have the chapter. Yes, about the MNCs and globalization, you have the chapter in paper 1. So that is only the thing we are studying here. No, kotta vishayam em kaadu manam chadavedi ippudu. So this is the globalization, means total it become as a global market. Okay, it become as a global market. All the companies started doing business all over the world. So globalization means the companies make the globe as a global market, means they started doing business all over the world. So due to globalization and rapid growing of economy, rapid growing of economy means due to development in the economy, may MNCs are coming to India. Due to this, some multinational companies are coming to India to do business in India. Okay, and operating their business in India, they're coming to India and they're operating means they're starting their business in India. Few top MNCs which are operating in India, few top companies, okay, few top MNC companies which are operating in India, means whose branches are in India. Few MNC companies, what are those? Microsoft, it is not an Indian company, but its branch in India. IBM, it is not an Indian company, but its branch in India. Nestle, it is not an Indian company, but its branch in India. PepsiCo, that is also, Pepsi company is also a foreign company. Sony Corporation, this is also a foreign company. These all are the foreign companies, but they are carrying on their activities in India also. Multinational corporations are grant firm with their headquarters. Yes, there will be one headquarter, means head office. Okay, head office will be located in one country. So headquarter will be located in one country and with a variety of business operations in several other country. Okay, multinational corporations have headquarter in one country and it has a variety of business operations in several other country. In several other countries, it will carry on its business operations. The MNCs that invest foreign direct investment. So with the help of MNCs, when MNCs come to the country, there will bring investment. That investment is known as foreign direct investment. They will bring that their country currency. For example, America, that is dollar. They bring the dollar to the India so that the India is receiving the foreign currency directly. Yes? India receiving the foreign currency directly. So in this way, we are getting investment from the MNC companies. That investment is the foreign direct investment. Okay, whatever the investment which you are receiving directly from the foreign countries in their currency value, okay, in dollar, yen, whatever it may be, those things are known as, those investment is known as foreign direct investment. These will be asked for 2 marks. Some of the Indian MNCs operating at global level are some of the Indian MNCs means their headquarter in India, but their business operations are carried on in different countries, in several other countries. What are those companies means? Infosys, Wipro, Reddy's Lab, etc. Similarly, Coca-Cola, Honda, BMW, IBM Computer and Pepsi Cola from US. Okay, these companies are from US. Which companies? Coca-Cola, Honda, BMW, IBM Computer and Pepsi Cola. These are from USA. And Sony and Honda that are from Japan. Yes. So, Indian companies are Infosys, Wipro, Reddy's Lab. These are the Indian companies. But they are carrying on their operations all over the globe. Okay, next let us see the definition that is given by Franklin Root. According to the Franklin Root, the MNCs as a parent company. MNCs are the parent companies. Why he is saying it as a parent companies? Because MNCs are not a small company. MNC means it is a multinational corporations, multinational companies. So those companies have huge capital, huge employees, huge amount of turnover. So that's why it is a parent company to all other companies. So engaged in foreign production through its associated with several countries. So these MNC companies are associated with several other countries, but its head office is located in one country, but its activities or operations which are carried on all over the globe. Okay, that's why I have drawn the globe. Exercise direct control over the policies. So whatever the policies are there in different areas, they will follow those countries' policies and they will continue their business operations regularly. Implements business strategy. Strategy means planning. They will implement the business plan, whatever the plan they have, how they have prepared, how to achieve their objectives, how to achieve their goals, whatever the plan they have prepared, that plan regarding the production or regarding the marketing or finance and staffing. Staffing means employment. Okay, production means producing of goods, marketing means selling of goods, finance means working capital, fixed capital. Staffing means employing the persons, how many employees are required, how many wage laborers are required, yes, how much management is required, how many chairpersons are required, board of directors, managing directors, those all fall under the category of staffing. The transcend national boundaries means they will move over the national boundaries, they will cross that nation boundary, India boundaries. For example, if you take the India as example of this definition, the MNC companies of India crossing the India boundaries and they're going out to other countries and following the whatever the policies are there, in that countries, and also they are implementing those things in order to continue their business successfully. Okay, so let us meet in the other session with the object, with the advantages and disadvantages of MNC. What are the advantages of MNCs and what are the disadvantages of MNCs? Let us meet in the other session with that topic. Yes.